Good morning, my dear students. In today, I am going to start Unit 5. Unit 5 is Information Theory and Channel Capacity. And this Information Theory deals with how to quantify the information and how efficiently the information is transmitted from source to destination. And second concept is channel capacity. In the channel capacity, we are going to deal with what is the capacity of the channel to transmit the information, how the bandwidth of the channel could be, and how the signal to noise ratio that affect the channel capacity. All these implications are studied in the channel capacity. This is completely about the capacity of the channel to transmit the information. And already you know that the aim of any communication system is to transfer of information from source to destination. Suppose first I am transmitted a message. That is hello, 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 hello. That is my message. The hello has been occurred 4 times. Then probability of hello is, you know that probability formula, probability P equal to number of times hello has occurred. Hello occurred 4 times, 4 by total number of outcomes also 4. 4 by 4, 1. That means the probability equal to 1. If the probability is high, that indicates very less information. All indicate same information, hello. That means if the probability is high, that indicates very less information. And suppose take second message. The second message is hello, 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 hi. And the probability of hi is, probability of hi is probability equal to number of times hi has occurred. Hi occurred 1 time, 1 by 4. The probability is low. That indicates a high information, because hi is a new word that indicates a new information. That means if the probability is low, that indicates a new information or a high information, a new information. Okay. If the probability is low, that indicates a new information or a more information. From this one, we can state the information content in the message is inversely proportional to the probability. The information content is inversely proportional to probability. Information content I of xi equal to log 2 of 1 by pxi, where p of xi indicates probability. The information content I of xi equal to log 2 of 1 by probability of xi. And from this definition, we have following points. The first point is the information I of xi equal to 0 for p of xi equal to 1. Suppose if p of xi equal to 1, I of xi equal to log 2 of 1 by 1, log of 1 is 0. And the second point is I of xi is greater than or equal to 0 for 0 less than or equal to p of xi less than or equal to 1. And the third point is I of xk greater than I of xi for p of xk less than p of xi. You can observe, if the probability of xk is less, p of xk is less, that means probability is less, then information is high. Probability of xk is less than probability of xi. That's why I of xk is greater than I of xi. That means the probability is low, the information is high. And next point, next important definition is entropy. This entropy is indicated with h of x. In practically, the source, suppose the source is x, the source is continuously transmitting a symbols, continuously transmitting more number of symbols, and this entropy indicates the average information. The formula for the entropy is h of x equal to summation I equal to 1 to m p of xi into I of xi, that is equal to summation I equal to 1 to m p of xi into I of xi is log 2 of 1 by p of xi. 1 by log 1 by logarithm of 1 by p is minus p. We write the minus term outside. And this entropy indicates number of bits per symbol. That's why the units are bits per symbol. It indicates a number of bits per symbol. On average, how many bits are required are indicated by this. And it indicates the average information content for source symbol. And the, for the entropy, the relation is 0 less than or equal to h less than or equal to log 2 base m. That means the lower limit for the entropy is 0 and upper limit for the entropy is log 2 m. And where m is the number of symbols of the source. Suppose the source is hexadecimal source, the number of symbols is 16. For hexadecimal source, the number of symbols are 16. Therefore, the relation is 0 less than or equal to h of x less than or equal to log 2 16. Log 2 of 16 is 4. That means the entropy for the hexadecimal source is varies from 0 to 4. And from this, from the entropy formula, we can have certain relations, certain points. The first point is, the entropy is 0 if one symbol having probability of 1, p of xk equal to 1 for some k, and all remaining probabilities are set to 0. That means, if one probability p of k equal to 1 and the remaining probabilities are 0. Remaining probabilities are 0. Already you know the formula h of x equal to summation I equal to 1 to m minus pi into log of pi. That means it is 1 for only one value. That is equal to 1 summation I equal to 1 to m 1 log of 1 and remaining values are 0. Log 1 is 0. You can get entropy also 0. That is first point. If the entropy is 0, if one probability is 1 and remaining probabilities are set to 0. And the second condition is, second point is, the entropy h of x equal to log 2 base m if probability equal to 1 by m. That means all symbols are equiprobable. You can get h of x equal to log 2 base m. Okay, this is about information and entropy. The information is indicated with I of xi, that is equal to I of xi equal to log 2 of 1 by p of xi, that is information. And entropy h of x equal to summation I equal to 1 to m pi into logarithm of 1 by p of xi. That is the formula for the entropy. Thank you very much.